also by the privilege given to me today, I'm sharing on engaging in giving for my beauty. Praise the Lord. Engaging in giving for my beauty. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Our other scripture is from 2 Corinthians chapter 9. 2 Corinthians chapter 9. Pray that God will give us understanding. And you might have heard about giving over and over. But may God give you a new revelation in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
2 Corinthians, can we read together? Chapter 9, verse 10 and 11. The Bible says, "Now he that ministereth seed to the sower, both minister bread for your food and multiply your seed sown." Amen.
Yes.
"And increase the fruit of your righteousness." Hallelujah.
Amen.
11. "Being enriched in everything to all bountifulness." Amen. "Which causes through us thanksgiving to God." Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I used to read that scripture the wrong way. I used to say, "He that ministers seed to the sower and bread to the eater." It is ministering seed to the sower, both minister bread. Amen. So it's not that he's giving bread to the eater. No. It's the sower who is being given bread. Amen. It is the sower who is giving, being given bread for his food. Amen. And apart just for the food, he's also given more seed to sow. Hallelujah. More seed to sow. Amen. So when a farmer goes to a field, we know about farming, okay? They plant, and then there is, let's say, maize especially. So they plant the maize, and then when they harvest the maize, there's a choice, the best ones. They keep it for the next season. Okay? They have something to eat, yes, but they have something to plant in the next season. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So the same it is when it comes to giving in the kingdom. Amen. When it comes to giving in the kingdom. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then this is something that will transform your life. Amen. It is something that has worked for me, for my family, and it's working for many of you here. Amen.
Amen.
To the glory of God. And if you engage in it, amen, you shall be enriched. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God. So God doesn't just give one seed. He also gives bread. He will give you seed, and then after the seed, after it is sown, he gives bread. That the harvest is your bread, amen? And also you get more seed to sow. Hallelujah. So seed time and harvest, it does not cease. Amen. Let's open Genesis chapter 8, verse 22. Story of Noah. Okay. Noah gave a seed, and then gave a sacrifice, okay, gave a sacrifice, and then God said, verse 22, "While the earth remained, seed time and harvest, and cold and heat, and summer and winter, and day and night shall not cease." Seed time and harvest shall not cease, amen?
Amen.
Seed time and harvest shall not cease. Hallelujah. So you don't say, okay, I've given, last year I gave my sacrificial, so this year let me relax. No, seed time and harvest shall not cease. So if you want your harvest to cease, stop giving. Okay? If you want your harvest to cease, stop giving. Praise the Lord. Amen. And what is a seed? A seed is what you sow. A seed is for sowing. A seed is for sowing. Like remember Miles Monroe, when he's talking about the potential, he says in every, there's a tree in every seed. There's a forest in every seed. Praise the Lord. But until it is sown, okay? Until you sow it, you won't see the tree, okay? You'll be having the seeds there for decoration. But the seed must be sown. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The seed must be sown. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The seed must be sown. So your seed can be your money. Amen. Your seed can be your time. Your seed can be your service in the kingdom. Okay?
Yeah.
The acts of kindness that you show to people. If you have the mentality, this is a seed I'm sowing. Tomorrow I will reap. Amen. Tomorrow I will reap. And then for the, like during this time, most of you have been doing one thing or the other. just to make sure things are running smoothly. Amen.
Amen.
That is your seed. Seed is a seed. Amen.
Amen.
I was telling the Lord as I'm doing my assignment, apart from ministering the word, as I'm doing this, Lord, let there be a time when there shall be, you know, many women. Amen.
Amen.
Many women willingly doing what I was doing, what I'm doing. Amen.
Amen.
And you know, and I know God answers prayer. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Which is my seed. So I say, that is the harvest that I want in the ministry, that people will be there to do even more than what we are doing right now.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Ecclesiastes chapter 11. It's good, you know, the scriptures can't lie. Amen.
Amen.
A man can speak and lie to you, but the scriptures will not lie. So you better believe the scriptures. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Ecclesiastes chapter 11. Verses 1 to 3. Bible says, cast your bread upon the waters, for thou shalt find it after many days. Give a portion to 7 and also to 8, for thou knowest not what evil shall be upon the earth. If the clouds be full of rain, they empty themselves, amen,
amen,
upon the earth. And if the tree fall towards the south or towards the north, in the place where the tree falleth, there it shall be. Praise the Lord. It says, cast your bread upon many waters, and thou shalt find it after many days. So you are in a season. The season you're in right now is a season of casting your bread. Amen.
Amen.
Casting your bread. Casting your bread. Remember when I was young, I didn't know much about. Okay, I was taught about giving, but of course my understanding has grown with time. And I remember when I started tithing when I was in high school, because that's when we were given pocket money. There was no pocket money in primary school, amen.
Yeah.
And I was so happy. I was so happy I could tithe in coins, okay? That's what was there. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
I could tithe in coins. You know, I don't say this is too small. No. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Give to God. Give to God what belongs to God.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
Then we are graduated, became my joint. The ministry, and then we were being taught expansively about seeds and sowing, amen.
Mm-hmm.
And I was plugging in, and as you've heard, those are the things that he gave a man of God 50 bob. That was what was in his budget, amen.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I budgeted for myself, like every month, this is what I'll be giving to, this is what I'll be giving to the men of God, giving to the men of God. And it was, I think, 100, yes, it be 100, it was 100 bob. Every month I give. You're not giving to him, you put it in the offering basket, write in your name, write your expectation, whether he reads it or doesn't, you are giving to God. Okay, God knows what you have written, amen.
Mm-hmm.
So, I remember one day, the man of God that time called me in his office. Then, he said, thank you, I've been receiving your. See, the man is saying thank you, whatever, I've been giving 100 more. Like for him, what is 100 bob? But that was my level. And I don't say I can't, it's too small. No, praise the Lord, that is your level at that time. So he called me and said, thank you, I've been receiving your seeds. And I was, holy. You know that car reference? Because this is a big man of God. And then he gave me an envelope. I said, Jehovah, thank God, my day of harvest. Amen. So when I went to my house, I found 2,000 shillings. I think I threw the offering away. I threw the envelope and said, what? You know, like, he could think, you know, to give me such a, praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
With my 100, praise the Lord.
Yeah.
But I thank God for that blessing. You know, I really bless the Lord. So I was casting my bread, praise the Lord, and that's one way I also received the harvest. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So the Bible says in verse 3 that if the clouds be full of rain, they empty themselves. If the clouds be full of rain, they empty themselves. So someone say, okay, so when do I start reaping? Praise the Lord. When do I start reaping? fill your clouds first. Amen. When the cloud is full, it has no choice but to empty itself. Amen. So this is your time to start filling your clouds. Amen. Fill your clouds. Fill your clouds. Fill your clouds with your giving. When they are full, they will empty themselves with rain. The season you're in now, it's a planting season. It's a time to be filling your clouds. Praise the Lord. Filling your cloud with seed. Filling your clouds with your service. It is your seed time. Amen. It is your seed time. I'm not surprised where God has taken us right now. Amen. But I know where I started from. Praise the Lord. We know where you started. Sometimes don't envy people. There's a story behind every glory. Amen. Don't envy anyone. Amen. They have done something to be where they are. So the thing is, the secret of men is in their stories. The secret of men is in their stories. Don't say, people are giving maybe towards, let's say, the pulpit, the decorations and all that. Say, okay, when God blesses Lord, don't say I don't have. A good example I know is about Kenneth Copeland, great man of God, amen. Amen. Great man of God, dangerously blessed. Praise the Lord. Some people are believing God for cars. Him is in aeroplanes, amen. Cars, it's aeroplanes, jets. Praise the Lord. Amen. And it's all because of. And where he started from, he started believing God, amen, believing God with the seed. And I remember giving a testimony that his wife was pregnant and there was a seed was called in church. They didn't have anything. The clothes that they were wearing, they were adding the material because the wife was pregnant. They could not afford the dresses, amen. So what I had was they gave the buttons of the dress, the buttons. So I'm like, don't say you don't have anything to give. Praise the Lord. Don't say you don't have anything to give. Where they live right now, the ministry they are running, amen. The people they are blessing today, amen. It's all to the glory of God. It's massive. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And also God gave us an example about when it comes to a seed. Exactly what is a seed? Praise the Lord. What is a seed? And he told in the book of Genesis, he told the devil that the seed of the woman shall crush your head. Serpent. Okay? The seed of the woman shall crush your head. Talking about Jesus. Praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. And when the Bible says, John 3:16, that God gave his only begotten son. Amen?
Yeah.
God was sowing his only begotten son. And do you know that was very costly? But I think that was very cheap for God. Because he's God, let me just give. No! Praise the Lord. No! Because Jesus said, my father, God forsaken. Why? Because all the sin of the world was on him. Praise the Lord. That it's like, God, the sin don't relate. That's why you could make that cry. Why forsaken? But God was sowing a seed. Now, I believe there are many angels there who have said, let me send you. No! God said, let me send my very best. Praise the Lord. Let me send my very best. Let me send my very best to the world. And imagine you and I are the harvest. Praise the Lord. Millions, billions across the world because of that one seed. Amen. Precious seed. Precious seed. Hallelujah. Precious seed. And also, it is at the point of giving that Abraham knew God as Jehovah Jireh. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Even Abraham had that test to give the very best. It was a sacrificial moment for Abraham to give Isaac. I love to have known what was really going through his mind. I mean, this is someone you've been waiting for 25 years. Then, amen. That was serious. Praise the Lord. That was serious. Amen. But we all say the blessing of Abraham today. The blessing of Abraham. And God saw. You know, after that time, God saw. Says in blessing I bless. in multiplying and multiplying. Praise the Lord. So if you want that kind of swearing, amen, start giving sacrificially to God.
Amen.
Practice giving sacrificially to God. Amen.
Amen.
Sacrificially to God. And because someone has shared a testimony when there was a sacrificial offering called upon in church. And then we say this is what you are going to give. It was a lot of money. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We say we gave it and said this when the offering basket left. We are looking at it like, have we really given? Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
But the Bible says that those who sow in tears shall return back with sheaves of harvest, rejoicing. Amen.
Amen.
Rejoicing, rejoicing. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So, and God has given us this kind of a system. This kind of a system about seeds and those. We are not like the world. Amen. The world will say, keep as much as you can. And the Bible says, he who scatters, praise the Lord, increases. That's the God system. He who scatters, increases. Amen.
Amen.
What have you been scattering? Praise the Lord. Let 2021 be our year of scattering abroad. I think that should be in Proverbs 11. As he that scattereth. 11:24. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Proverbs 11:24. There is that scattered and yet increasing. Amen?
Amen.
You scatter but you're increasing. Amen. That's God's system. And there's that withholdeth more than is meat, but it tended to poverty. It tended to, you think you're holding because to survive, yet you're holding poverty. Which is poverty you're holding. Praise the Lord. I remember there's a time I was leading the choir, the youth choir at that time. And then there was a you know, we are giving to us uniforms. Okay? We are giving to us uniforms. Any opportunity to give, have the mentality I'm sowing. Have the mentality of a farmer that this is not just I'm giving for uniform, but no, have the mentality I'm sowing. And then there are those who are dividing, they don't want to give. Then God told me that is withholding more than is meat. There is a need and you're withholding. If there is a need and you think you're withholding, because maybe I don't want to give, there are some richer guys here that mean they will support me. Why can I see where you are supporting? Okay? And you have something, it's not like you don't have anything. That is withholding more than is meat. You're withholding more than is meat because there is something you can give. Praise the Lord. There is something you can give towards whatever project it is. There is something you can give. Not say you have nothing. Amen. Don't say you have nothing and yet you're always online. Don't say you have nothing. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Then verse 25. The liberal soul shall be made fat. Hallelujah. And he that watereth shall be watered also himself. Praise the Lord. Shall be watered also himself. You water, God waters you back.
Amen.
God waters you back.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So you're giving, give God something to work with to increase you financially. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You're giving, give God something to work with to increase you financially.
Yeah.
So if you're not giving anything, God has nothing to work with. God has nothing to work with to increase you. Praise the Lord. God has nothing to work with. And we'll see this. Your giving now will affect your tomorrow. You see this as you continue. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
As you continue. Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
But then your giving has to be done by faith. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
Your giving, in fact, must be in faith. So then can you imagine, I go and my farm and I plant, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I plant. The harvest season comes, I don't even know. You know? I don't know that I even planted. I don't know even I have a farm. That's what many of us do. We just give carelessly. Okay? Now unakaa tu juu kama. So you don't even know there's a seed you gave. It is so irresponsible. See, you don't imagine a farmer peane and then have a season is going to his neighbor tomorrow. Give me. Yet they have planted the same thing. But because of his irresponsibility, is just waiting for others to. I mean, it's not even practical. You know when you are planted. A farmer will know when he has sown. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
A farmer will know when he has sown. Lord, should be Brother Copeland says, or Mike Mundo says, document your seeds. Okay? Know what you've sown. Know what you've sown. ndio hata sikikuja usichangae. Ah, okay. You don't know whether you planted maize or beans. No, that is very responsible. So know what you're planting. Know what you're planting. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Know what you're planting. I'm saying giving has to be given by faith. Abel gave by faith. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Gave by faith. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 10. Faith is believing that what God has promised is able to perform. That is faith. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. 9 verse 10. 9 verse 10. So 1 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 10. The Bible says, for say he eat together for our sakes. For our sakes, no doubt this is written, that he that ploweth should plow in hope. Okay? And that he that threshes in hope should be partaker of this hope. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And hope is the foundation of faith. Amen. Mm-hmm. You are plowing in hope. You know, this one tomorrow, I will harvest it. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
I will harvest. Hallelujah. I will harvest.
Mm-hmm.
Glory to God. If you sow, you sow in hope. Without hope, faith has nothing to bring to pass.
Mm-hmm.
Without hope, faith has nothing to bring to pass.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
Faith has nothing to bring to pass. And I thank God for we were called upon, amen.
Mm-hmm.
Someone of God said, it's time to give for this, amen.
Mm-hmm.
And it was the first one, praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
It was the first one. He was giving the answer. I said, eh? Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Said, instead of let me not be surprised, let me plug in, amen.
Mm-hmm.
Let me also plug in, praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And I bless the Lord because men and women here gave.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Gave out of understanding. Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
May God also beautify your lives,
mm-hmm,
as you beautify the sanctuary in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
So what are the avenues of giving? And what are we see also the, what is the blessing in those giving? Givings. Praise the Lord. In those givings. First one, we begin with tithes and offerings. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Tithes, offerings. Tithes and offerings. And we have been taught that tithe is not just the 10%. We all know 10%, 10%, 10%. If you give that, it's okay. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
But that's just the beginning. That people have given God 90%. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
We have given God 90%. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So tithe is a percentage to give to God. Of course, not below 10%. Above. Amen. Because God has given us so much. So what is 10%?
Amen.
God has given you 1,000, you're giving him 100 gold. God has given you 100, you're giving him 10 gold. Okay? So if you, I think, of course, giving must be out of love. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Giving must be out of love. So, like, if you, sometimes even in the temple, you're like, let me add this one. It's so small. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
But according to your ability, amen?
Mm-hmm.
Tithes and offerings. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
About tithe. A very, very powerful covenant practice. Let me read from Hebrews chapter 7. Hebrews chapter 7, verse 8. Hebrews chapter 7, verse 8. I love this scripture. Bible says, and here men that die receive tithes. Okay? And here, we are here on earth. Men that die receive tithes. But there in heaven, he received them. Jesus, of whom it is witness that he liveth. So when I'm giving my tithe here, praise the Lord,
mm-hmm,
I'm giving on earth, but it's a spiritual transaction. Every giving is a spiritual transaction. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
If your faith is in place, amen. I'm giving it here, but Jesus is receiving it there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus is receiving my tithe in heaven at the same time. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
But there, it is here we give to men that die. Of course, when you're giving, you're not giving, you won't tell God, okay, take. How we praise the Lord. To be used for the work of the ministry, amen.
Amen.
But you're given here to men that are not all men, but there he received it then. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
To whom it is witness that he lives. So that means if he's still living, my tithe has not died.
Mm.
My giving is not dead.
Mm.
My giving is alive.
Amen.
So it will speak for me tomorrow. Praise the Lord. It is alive. Praise the Lord. It will speak for me tomorrow. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. And we know about Malachi chapter 3 verse 10. Thank God for one of you was very eager to know about the avenues of giving. I had a session, we talked, and then she really plugged in. Amen.
Amen.
She dived in with all her being, and I was like, okay. Amen.
Amen.
With understanding. Malachi chapter 3, verse 10. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse that I may meet in mine house, and prove me now. Glory to God. God is telling you to prove him. That's the only place God is saying, prove me now. Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're giving for that tithe for your business, you're proving God, I'm proving you. Let, you know, see what happens. See the beauty of this. Prove me now here, it says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing. Praise the Lord. Not blessings, a blessing. That there shall not be room enough to receive it. A blessing. A blessing. A blessing, that is what will bring blessings. Amen.
Amen.
The blessing of the Lord maketh rich. Bible says, the blessing of the Lord maketh rich and added no sorrow in it. I'll open up and give you the blessing. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And then, of course, there's our worship offerings. Amen. There's our worship offerings. There are time. Who gave offerings to the Lord. You can see that in Exodus, Leviticus, the offerings, our worship offerings that we come to God every Sunday, you say, the offerings apart from tithes are worship offerings. Amen.
Amen.
Worship offerings. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 14, verse 20. You can just write that and maybe read on your own. And then there's another avenue of giving apart from our tithes and offering. Is giving to the prophets or to the men of God. Amen?
Amen.
Giving to the men of God. And I think I've already shared that testimony. Giving to the men of God. Glory to God.
Amen.
And what is there after giving? Thank God, God does not tell you to do something for nothing.
Amen.
Amen. No, he's not that kind of a God. Galatians chapter 6, verse 6 to 7, Bible says, let him that is taught in the word communicate unto him that teacheth in all good things. Are you seeing that?
Mm-hmm.
Let him that is taught in the world communicate unto him that teacheth in all good things. Be not deceived, God is not mockful. So ever a man soweth, that shall he reap. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
God is not mocked. Ever a man soweth, that shall he reap. Unfortunately, many use that verse in the negative. He shall reap what he sowed. Amen. Hallelujah. It says, let him that is taught in the word communicate unto him that teacheth. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
So something should come from you. God has ordained the men of God to be fed from the altar. Okay? Let me show you that. 1 Corinthians 9:14. And those who complain, oh, why are men of God blessed? No. That should not be part of your talk. Amen. I love what Paul said. Paul said, he knew that that's how he was supposed to live by the church giving to him. But he says he did not misuse that opportunity. So the problem is when the men of God now misuse it. And you know, let me not go there. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, 14 says, even so, as the Lord ordained that they which preach the gospel should live of the gospel. Amen?
Amen.
Should live of the gospel. Amen.
Amen.
In fact, men of God should be very blessed. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Because they handle the spirit. They handle the spirit. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And they are supposed to reap carnal things from those whom they minister to. Amen.
Amen.
Ezekiel 44, verse 30. I'm saying, you're not believing any man's. People have told you to give. Believe the word of God because it can't lie. So that's why we will be reading many scriptures today. You see it for yourself. See it for yourself and let your faith be built up. Amen?
Amen.
To start acting. Praise the Lord. To start acting. Maybe where you are, this is not a very common practice. Do it on your own. Amen. Do it. Start doing it on your own with faith. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Uh-huh. 44, Ezekiel 44, that the Bible says that the first of all, the first fruits of all things and every obligation of all, of every sort of your obligation, shall be the priests. Okay? Ye shall also give unto the priest the first of your dough, that he may cause the blessing to rest in thine house. Amen. The priest will cause the blessing to rest in your house because you have given your first, you have given your best. You know, the choice things you have given to the priest, and he will cause, because he has the power to cause the blessing to rest in your house. Amen? Amen. He has the power to cause the blessing to rest in your house. Hallelujah. Amen. Remember when the widow of Zarephath, he was giving to God. Have that mentality, I'm giving to God. Praise the Lord. Yes. Because this is a man of God. He gave to what was this? Elijah. Okay? Gave to Elijah, he gave to the man of God, amen. And see what happened. The blessing, the prophet caused the blessing to rest in the house. For three years, they did not have lack. Because of that one seed, they gave to the man of God, amen. So that is your avenue. God has given us avenues for our increase financially. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And that God servant doesn't. He's not the kind that says, oh, give to me. No, praise the Lord. Amen. He's a blessed man. Sometimes, if you don't give to them because you see there's a need, no, praise the Lord. Amen. In fact, when they are very blessed, they tend to give. Amen. Amen. Because you saw where you want to go. Praise the Lord. Amen. Where do you want to go? That's where I want to go. Give. Some people don't even need what you're giving. Amen. Amen. But you know what you need. Amen. You want to get there. You want to get that grace. You want to provoke blessings in your own house. Hallelujah. So you give to the men of God. Then giving to kingdom advancement. Giving to kingdom advancement. Some have been given for the transport, the pulpit, the decoration. That is part of kingdom. Kingdom advancement. Hallelujah. For the ministry, for evangelism. Hallelujah. You are giving to kingdom advancement. Glory to God. I was listening to the bishop and say that when they were as in They have built churches. Him and his wife. Nothing from the pocket of the church. Okay? Him and they have built churches, praise the Lord. And how did they start? He started when he was in high school. Okay? I think they still say they don't have a place to worship. He said, okay, do you have land? Yes. Okay. So he started giving. He said he didn't have, there was no savings anywhere for him now to like start building a sanctuary for the guys to come and fellowship. But he started like, maybe it's one brick in green. Amen. You know, go, praise the Lord. Not that now he's building churches that he doesn't even know like how it is going, but it is being built. Amen. With what God has blessed him, nothing coming from the church. You know, he's very blessed. Praise the Lord. Amen. Independently of the church, they are building sanctuaries. They praise the Lord. So you're giving to kingdom advancement. Hallelujah. Don't say, okay, listen, God bless me with 10,000. I'll have something to give. You will not give. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Start, if yours is 1,000 right now, start giving that from that 1,000. Amen. Yes. Start giving from that 1,000. Hallelujah. Psalm 102, verse 12. 13. 102 verses 12 says, for thy servants take pleasure in our stones. Those are the stones of Zion, okay? And favor the dust thereof. So the verse 13 says, thou shalt arise and have mercy upon Zion, for the time to favor her. We should say the amen. We in Zion.
Amen.
Thou shalt arise and have mercy upon Zion. Amen. For the time to favor her. Hallelujah. As we pray. Yes, the said time is come. Amen. 2021 is our time of favor.
Yes.
Time of favor. Time of favor in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For the servants, why is God arising to have favor on us? For thy servants take pleasure in our stones. Amen. It is your pleasure to. The stones means as you're building, it is your pleasure, the stones. You want to see the church decorated and you favor the dust thereof. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. You favor the dust thereof. Hallelujah. Those are whatever is happening in Zion. Your heart is there. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
You want the the church to be beautified. Praise the Lord. David says, you know, it was to build the sanctuary, and then God says, no, it's your son that will do it. Then, but he said, that did not stop him. He said, of my own proper goods have I kept, there's gold, there's silver, you know, just for the sake of the house of God. Amen. Amen. I have kept of my own proper goods. Hallelujah. Amen. He had the passion to see the house of God built. Amen. Amen. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. And that's kingdom advancement, the projects in church, and also giving to the poor and the needy. Amen. This is blessing humanity. Don't say you're walking in faith that your sister is lacking bus fare. Amen. Amen. So give to them. Give to them. Proverbs 19:17. The Bible says, he that has pity upon the poor lendeth unto the Lord. Praise the Lord. And that which he has given, will he pay him again. Praise the Lord. God will pay you for what you've given him. Amen. He doesn't, is, you know, there are people you give and they never pay back. Amen. People that 40 years, you get tired. God says, I will pay him again. Amen. Because you have had mercy on the poor. You have had mercy on the needy. You can also write Deuteronomy 7:7 and read it at your own time. Then also there's giving to parents. Praise the Lord. Giving to our parents. Ephesians 6:1-2. This is because, I think this was shared yesterday. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Shared yesterday. Honor thy father and mother. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Honor thy father and mother, and shall be well with thee. Praise the Lord. Shall be well with thee. Ephesians 6:1-2. Then there are some guys in the book of Jeremiah 35. Obeyed the commands of the Father, and let's see what happened. Verse 18. The Bible said, and Jeremiah said unto the house of Rechabites, thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, because you have obeyed the commandment of Jonadab, your father, and kept all his precepts, and done according to all that he has commanded you. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, Jonadab, the son of Rechab, shall not want a man to stand before me forever. Praise the Lord. These were children that obeyed the commands of their father. Hallelujah. The commands of their father. Start small. Amen. You don't know how much that carries when you. It's not that because they need your money, okay? At this level, maybe. Maybe at time you come and then you're the only one maybe responsible for taking care of them. But then it's not that you're not giving them because you feel like this is your. Of course, it's been commanded, yes? It's been commanded, but give them because you love them. Give them because you honor them. Some even don't deserve what you're giving them. Praise the Lord. But because you honor them and you want it to be well with you. Hallelujah. You want it to be well with you. Give to them. Praise the Lord. Give to them. Remember, you've been given to our parents since, because we got married, and it's part of our budget what we give every month, now and then. And then, also said, there's some money you needed at some point, and whatever we were waiting for, it not coming yet. So we said, okay, let me ask my parents. They have the ability, they can give us this share. And then when our money comes, we just turn it back to them. So I wrote to them a message and all that. So by the time I think they're seeing the message and responding, they send the money, we had already gotten what we wanted. So I said, let me just return this money to them, return it back. Okay. So my mother was, why are you returning the money? I said, but we have what we wanted, so it's okay. Can have the money. I said, do you know what your dad said? What did he say? He said, I'm the only one who has not really eaten his money. Praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. If my father can say that, as in Jabula Pisaki Mzuri. So it was a joy for him to give me because I just asked. Okay? Mm-hmm. But that stems from my relationship. They know I honor them, okay? They know I was very obedient since I was a child. You should tell my mom, my daughter is very obedient. She said, you are like that when you are young. I said, you're a praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. So it's like any parent will love an obedient child. It's just automatic. Don't say, if ever this, if you are, no. It's automatic. Praise the Lord. So because of that relationship, and because we've been honoring them, of course, giving unto them, you know, it's not even much that you give. Praise the Lord. We're giving at our level this time. But because of just that part, they feel they can give us anything. Praise the Lord. And it wasn't small money. Say, no, just keep it. I wish you did not return it back. Mom said, I wish you send it to me instead of sending it to that. Praise the Lord. So give to your parents. Have a plan you can give to your parents. Amen?
Amen.
Some of you are in businesses, and maybe whatever you're making, just say, Mom, let me bless you with this. Mm-hmm. Buy her something. Buy her a shoe. Praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. Bless them. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And then there's a... And this is a powerful one. That's what we were talking about in the beginning. There's sacrificial giving. Amen? Sacrificial giving. This is what we learn from Isaac and Abraham and Isaac. This is what God did when he gave his only begotten son. Sacrificial giving. Praise the Lord. I think I've shared a testimony here. Sacrificial offering was called for. You know, that's not just the normal offering. Praise the Lord. It's sacrificial offering. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So, my employer that time, they went to Bangkok. Okay, went to Bangkok, I think with the wife and some team of people. And then when she came, the wife bought me a very nice handbag. Okay, very nice handbag. Those times you could give anything, material, financial. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So I said, what will I give God? Hallelujah. Of course, that was my first, I think, new handbag I had been given. I was using Tumba. So I looked at this handbag. I said, God, it is well. Let me close my eyes. Let me give it to God. Amen. Let me just give it. So at the offering time, I fungad it vizuri, put it in the offering basket. Praise the Lord. So I don't know whether they realized I had given because they don't see me with a bag, you know, and all that. But I gave. I gave that very costly. Amen. Very costly. From Bangkok, hand delivered. Praise the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I gave it to God. Then at the time I was working, I think, side by city. Not that, and I did have a jumper. Okay? I did have a jumper. Then my mom, I was living with my mom, and then he bought me a jumper. Okay? Then the year came, we were giving. So that jumper that I was giving, I folded it and gave it to God. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Gave it to God. Hallelujah. I thank God for that. It was my seed time. Amen. It was something precious to me. David said that I'll not give to God that which costs me nothing. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And he was so, don't be, okay, what will I get? You know, there are people who are zealous for God, like, God, I give you. Yeah? You don't even know I've given you. Praise the Lord. Amen. And it's with such kind of givings that God even swears blessings to us.
Amen.
Amen. That God swears blessings to us. Second, in Genesis chapter 22. It's good to ask yourself, what have I given God this year sacrificially? Okay? So if you... You know you're given sacrificially. Amen. You know you're given sacrificially. 22:16. This is the story of, we were talking about Abraham. See what God said. And then an angel of the Lord called unto Abraham out of heaven the second time, saying, by myself, praise the Lord. By myself have I sworn, says the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing, okay, and hast not withheld thy son, thine only son. God notices you have done that thing for him. You have not withheld that thing that you call precious. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
That in blessing, look at what that provoked. That in blessing I bless thee. Praise the Lord. in multiplying and multiply thy seed. Some things, even what we have or what you see, people are blessed. It's not because they have worked for that. No, it is the blessing. Remember the blessing we saw in Malachi? It is the blessing. In blessing, I bless thee. I'll multiply thy seed as the stars of the heaven and the sun which is upon the seashore, and thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemies. Hallelujah. The gate of his enemies. Glory to God.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So when we are called upon to give sacrificially, give sacrificially. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Give sacrificially and see what blessing that brings. So how do we give? How do we give? Say number one, giving must be in faith. Praise the Lord. Giving must be in faith. Giving must be done in faith. Because God is a rewarder. Amen.
Amen.
Hebrews 11, 4. Hebrews 11, 4. By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice, okay, than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God satisfying of his gift, and by it, he being dead, yet speaketh. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
He being dead, yet speaketh. Your offering will speak even after your long gone.
Amen?
Amen. Your sacrifice will speak long after you're gone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. Amen. Then how do you give? You give willingly. There has to be willingness. Anytime a giving someone is giving and you feel like you're being coerced, don't give. There is no blessing in that. I've been in many places actually and you feel like, hey, you have been coerced to give this offering. Let me just give. Praise the Lord. Please let me, people not see me sitting down. Let me go with the rest. That does not attract any blessings. Amen. That is out of coercion. Praise the Lord. Give willingly. 2 Corinthians 8, 12. Give willingly. Not the compassion or necessity. Bible says verse 12, for if there be first a willing mind. First you have to be willing. A willing mind. It is accepted. According to that a man has not. According to that he has not. Amen?
Amen.
If there first there has to be a willing mind. Amen?
Amen.
A willing mind. So be willing. And then read it, another way, give cheerfully. You know that scripture. 2 Corinthians 9 verse 7. Every man according as he has purposed in his heart. So let him give. Amen. Not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. Praise the Lord. God loves a cheerful giver. Give the Lord cheerfully. Amen.
Amen.
Give the Lord cheerfully. Give the Lord willingly. Even when you receive a gift from someone who is willing, you receive, you are happy.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
And I don't know whether you have given something to someone, and or someone has given you something, and the way they are giving it to you, do I take it or not? Amen. Do I take it or not take it? Praise the Lord. Because of how they are giving. And then give bountifully. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This is not very much, really taught so much. Giving bountifully. Giving bountifully. Pen up or winky. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Verse 6, same chapter. 2 Corinthians 9, 6. But this I say, he that soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly. If someone has another version, can reap that for me, please. And he that soweth bountifully shall also reap bountifully. Amen.
Amen.
Bountifully. Bountiful harvest. You want a bountiful harvest? Give bountifully. Another version?
Remember this. Whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. And whoever sows generously will also reap generously.
Amen. Give generously. Amen. Generously. Generously. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And also, as we read in Ecclesiastes chapter 11 verse 3, give continuously. Remember, you're giving to fill your clouds. Amen?
Yeah.
Give continuously. Give continuously. Ecclesiastes 11 verse 3. And as you have just read, give sacrificially. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Give sacrificially. It is called upon giving sacrificially. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Glory to God. So 1 Kings chapter 17. 1 Kings 17, as we wrap up. First Kings 17:14-16. Where we quoted earlier. So, but we, let's not just focus on the giving on it, amen?
Amen.
But also on the receiving. Praise the Lord. We have given, but we have not been taught how to receive. Everybody knows give. People give, but you have not been taught how to receive. Just like this, the farmer that you plant, you don't know whether you planted. It's in a mare, you don't even know. Okay? So you're not expecting this. You don't expect a harvest. So when you're giving to God, expect a harvest. Amen. Amen. Expect it. 14, this is the window. The Bible says, for that him, and the lady said unto her, fear not, go and do as thou hast said, and make me therefore a little cake first, and bring it unto me, and make after for thee and for thy son. For thus says the Lord of Israel, the barrel of meal shall not waste, neither shall the cruse of oil fail until the day that the Lord sendeth rain upon the earth. And she went and did according to the saying of Elijah. And she and he and her house did eat many days. Amen.
Yes.
And the barrel of meal wasted not, neither did the cruse of oil fail, according to the word of the Lord which she spake to Elijah. Remember that I was giving to the man of God, I was just saying my cruse of oil shall not fail. Amen.
Amen.
My barrel of meal shall not fail in the name of Jesus Christ. So what happens when we give? So what kind of harvest, what kind of things should you be looking for? Out for, okay? Giving secures the grace of God. Your giving secures the grace of God. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians 9:8. Secures for the grace of God. And giving is one thing that can answer all round, not just in money, like the harvest, not the money that you're receiving in the harvest, anything, praise the Lord. You can sow for your school fees.